Welcome back to the video series on permutation and combination. In the previous video, already we have discussed on the combination and also we have discussed on some problems of combination. In this video, we will discuss some more problems on combination. Let's start with the first example. We have to find the values of N and R. If n p r is given as n p r plus 1 and n c r is given as n c r minus 1. So n p r is equal to given as n p r plus 1. So n p r means n factorial upon n minus r factorial. And n p r plus 1, that means n factorial upon n minus r plus 1 factorial. So we have n minus r factorial means n minus r and n minus r plus 1 factorial. So that one is equal to n factorial upon n minus r 1 plus 1 factorial. So we can divide these two. So and n factorial. So 1 by n minus r is now 1. So n minus r is given as 1. So that is our first deduction. Second one, we have ncr is equal to ncr minus 1. So ncr means n factorial upon r factorial and n minus r factorial. And ncr minus 1 means n factorial upon r minus 1 factorial and n minus r plus 1 factorial. So we can divide n factorial. Moreover, r factorial means r into r minus 1 factorial. So r minus 1 factorial can be divided. Moreover, n minus r factorial, that can be written as n minus r factorial, but n minus r plus 1, that can be written as n minus r plus 1 into n minus r factorial. So n minus r factorial can be divided. So from here we can say 1 by r is now 1 by n minus r plus 1. Or from here we can say n minus r plus 1 is equal to r, or n minus r is equal to r minus 1. Now previously we have n minus r is equal to 1. So from 1 and 2 we get that n minus r is equal to 1, and so 1 is equal to r minus 1, because n minus r means 1. So we are writing it here. So r is equal to 2. Now put r is equal to 2 in equation 1. Here we are getting n minus r is equal to 1, so n minus 2 is equal to 1, so we are getting n is equal to 3. So finally we can say n is equal to 3 and r is equal to 2. Let's check the next problem. Here the question is given, if 10cr is to 12cr plus 1 has been given 9 is to 44, then we have to find the value of r. So 10cr is to 12cr plus 1 is equal to 9 is to 44. So write down the 10cr. So 10cr divided by 12cr plus 1 is equal to 9 upon 44. So 10cr means 10 factorial upon r factorial, 10 minus r factorial. And 12cr plus 1 means 12 factorial upon r plus 1 factorial and 12 minus r plus minus 1 factorial. So that one is equal to 9 by 44. So 10 factorial upon r factorial, 10 minus r factorial into r plus 1 factorial. That means that one is 12 minus r minus 1 factorial upon 12 factorial is equal to 9 by 44. Now write down the 12 factorial at first as 12 into 11 into 10 factorial. So we can divide 10 factorial. Then r factorial means r factorial, and 10 minus r factorial means 10 minus r factorial. Look at the r plus 1 factorial. So it can be written as r plus 1 into r factorial. So we can divide r factorial. And 12 minus r minus 1. that can be 11 minus r into 10 minus r factorial. So we can divide 10 minus r factorial. So that one is becoming r plus 1, that one 11 minus r into 11 minus r as the numerator. Then divided by 12 into 11 is equal to 9 by 44. So r plus 1 into 11 minus r means 9 by 44 into 132. That means 12 into 11. So from left hand side, we can say 11r minus r square plus 11 minus r is equal to 27. Or r square minus 10r plus 16 is equal to 0. Or after factorization, we can say r minus 2 into r minus 8 is equal to 0. So r has the values 2 and 8. Now proceed with the next problem. Question is, if ncr minus 1 is to ncr is to ncr plus 1 has been given 3 is to 4 is to 5. Find n and r. So we have ncr minus 1 is to ncr as 3 is to 4. So we are writing ncr minus 1 as n factorial upon r minus 1 factorial into n minus r plus 1 factorial. And NCR means n factorial upon r factorial and n minus r factorial. And right hand side is equal to 3 by 4. So n factorial upon r minus 1 factorial, n minus r plus 1, n minus r factorial into r minus 1 factorial. That means r factorial can be written in that way. And n minus r factorial upon n factorial. So we can divide n factorial, r minus 1 factorial, and n minus r factorial. So that one is equal to 3 by 4. So we have r by n minus r plus 1 as equal to 3 by 4. Or 4r is equal to 3n minus 3r plus 3. So we have the first equation, 3n minus 7r is equal to minus 3. Let's deduct the next equation. So we can write NCR is to NCR plus 1 as equal to 4 is to 5. So NCR upon NCR plus 1 is equal to 4 by 5. NCR means N factorial upon R factorial into N minus R factorial. And NCR plus 1 now that is divided. So it is in reverse form. R plus 1 factorial, N minus R minus 1 factorial upon N factorial. So we can divide N factorial. Now, r factorial, r plus 1 factorial can be written as r plus 1 into r factorial. So we can divide r factorial. Then n minus r factorial can be written as n minus r into n minus r minus 1 factorial. And there is also in the numerator n minus r minus 1 factorial. So we can divide those also. So finally, it is becoming r plus 1 and divided by n minus r is equal to 4 by 5. So we can say 5r plus 5 is equal to 4n minus 4r, or 4n minus 9r is equal to 5. That is our equation number 2. So solving the equation first, that is 3n minus 7r is equal to minus 3, and solving the 4n minus 9r is equal to 5, the second equation, from here we can say that minus r is equal to minus 27, or r is equal to 27, and put the value of r is equal to 27 in equation 1. So here 3n minus 7 into 27 is equal to minus 3, or 3n minus 189 is equal to minus 3, or 3n is equal to 186. So n is equal to 62. So r is equal to 27 and n is equal to 62. Now proceed to the next problem. Here a very simple and small question. In how many ways a team of 11 can be selected from a group of 15? Now when we are thinking about a team and we are selecting among 15 players, a team of 11 players. So that means the order or the sequence or the arrangement is not required. If we think about 1, 2, 3 up to 11 or 11 to 1, there would be no problem for any team. So that must be a K case of combination. So the required number of OS is equal to among 15, we have to select 11. That means 15C11. So 15 factorial upon 11 factorial and 15 minus 11 factorial. So 15 into 14 into 13 into 12 into 11 factorial. So we can divide 11 factorial and 4 factorial. We have 15 into 14 into 13 into 12 upon 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, or the result is 1365. So in that way, we can solve the problems on combination. In the next video, we will discuss more problems, practically more what problems on combination.